الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وبعد، if anyone claims something, for example, I believe something, then you have to have an evidence for that claim to support your claim. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is challenging us in the Quran when he says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to them, if you really believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you love him, then follow me, as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as an example, as a messenger of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you claim you believe. So anyone that claims iman, good deeds are indicative of that iman. The existence of that iman in the heart is secret between the person and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People cannot tell who is telling the truth and who is not. The only indication is that we have to use as a proof of evidence that this person maybe, you know, have iman, is if we see them engaging good deeds all the times. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying in hadith, if you see someone coming to Isha prayer and Fajr prayer in the mosque, فَاشْهَدُوا لَهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ. You test a witness for that person or testify for that person that he has iman, a faith, or a mu'min, better than Muslim. فَاشْهَدُوا لَهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ. And it's also بَرَاءَةً مِنَ النِّفَاقِ. It will be also a proof that this person is not munafiq. Because these two salat, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, are hard on munafiqeen, on hypocrites. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you mercy or showers you his ni'mah, you have blessed with something, maybe property, maybe health, maybe knowledge, maybe physical health, maybe children, maybe. The ni'mah of Allah are a lot. وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you try to count and number the mercies and abilities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us, Allah says you cannot count. You cannot count. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a mercy, he wants that mercy or that ni'mah to be acknowledged by you. You need to give the shukri back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the indicatives of that shukr or thanking or praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or being appreciative to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is when you act according to Allah's calls. When Allah calls you, you accept the call. When Allah asks you to give sadaqah, you give sadaqah. When Allah asks you to go and help others, you take the call. Whenever the Quran says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, you pay attention and you try to fulfill and implement what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you to do it. That's one of the things that can indicate that you have solid iman and you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are doing this for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the things that the ayat or the verses that we've been reading when we were praying mentioned is the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to us upon the animal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِي خَلَقَ الْأَزْوَاجَ كُلَّهَا وَجَعَلَ لَكُم مِّنَ الْفُلْكِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ مَا تَرْكَبُونَ. Allah is the one who created every type of creation from two opposite genders, plus or minus, male or female, something like that. And then Allah says, وَجَعَلَ لَكُم مِّنَ الْفُلْكِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ مَا تَرْكَبُونَ. He is the one who made the boats or the ships on the sea and the animals, from the animals to ride, some of them to ride, like horses, like camels, like donkeys, we ride. Allah is the one who gave us that ability to ride this big animal. Sometimes you see people riding elephant. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the ni'mah of Allah. And Allah says, next ayah, when مِنَ الْفُلْكِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ تَرْكَبُ لِتَسْتَوُوا عَلَى ظُهُورِهِ ثُمَّ تَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ رَبِّكُمْ. Look, you go and reside on top of that animal or the boat or the ship The boat and the ship are on the sea. They walking on and moving on water. They can sing. Who is holding it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That big object is standing on water. And if you throw a small metal into the water, it's sinking. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Has nothing to do with engineering. Of course, Allah makes everything for sabab. And this sabab is the engineering ability and the skills. But who gave that skills and the ability to the humanist? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now Allah says, I gave you ability to ride the animals, the big animals, or that big object walking or moving over the water. And then Allah says, لِتَسْتَوُوا عَلَى ظُهُورِ ثُمَّ تَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ رَبِّكُمْ. When you go and engage riding the animal or the other object, this man-made object is that is made for ride, like i.e. cars, planes, whatever, all of them. Allah says, تَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ رَبِّكُمْ. You mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy upon you. You mention the glad tidings or the ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you. Ni'mah is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to mention it. What do you say? سبحان الذي سخر لنا هذا وما كنا له مقرنين وإنا إلى ربنا لمنقلبون. That's the adhkar we read all the times when we ride on something and we are stabilize ourselves on the ride. This is what you say. سبحان الذي سخر لنا هذا. Praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Exalt is to Allah due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who made this possible for us. Allah is the one who made this animal to accept our ride. Otherwise, they would have killed us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that's making them to allow you to ride over them. So you say mercy is due to Allah, the one who made this animal rideable. The one who made them accept our ride. We would not be able. Otherwise, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps us to ride on them or to try to put that big metal, you see that big metal, which is the ship, to put on the water. While we cannot put small object, small piece of metal in the water, it will sink right away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the ability to put that big metal on the surface of the water and then ride them and put so much loads upon them and make it as heavy as possible and still walks and moves on the surface of the water without sinking. So mention Allah. Mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, acknowledging His mercies upon you is peace or great peace of shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we don't give that shukr back to Allah, if we don't acknowledge the ni'mah of Allah, then we will acknowledge the ni'mah of the ni'mah to the shaitan or to ourselves. You see many times, many people, they make good money, they have good lives. And if you ask about how they get this life, they say they're smart. Stay smart. You know, I studied hard. I work hard. It's this is nothing but a product of a hard work. I remind you one thing. That was said by someone before. And that someone was Qarun. Inna Qaruna kana min qawmi Musa fabagha alayhim. Wa ataynahu min al-kunuzi ma inna mafatihahu latanu'u bil-usbati ulil-quwa. Idh qala lahu qawmuhu la tafrah inna Allah la yuhibbu al-farihin. قال إنما أوتيته على علم عندي. That's what he said. Allah gave him so much money, so much wealth, up to a level that the keys, his keys of his saves, that hold or saves his property or money, were heavier to be able to be lifted by a group of people. His keys could not be lifted by a group of people. And then some of his friends recognized the arrogance in this person. And they said, La tafra, don't be arrogant. Give the shukri back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Acknowledge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that gave you this ni'mah. And you know what he said? I am a scholar. I have a knowledge. This is nothing but something I earn through my knowledge. Allah did not give me anything. There is no free ride. You can hear the kuffar saying such a thing all the times. And even some Muslims are falling into the trap. of relying upon themselves and their skills. And I'm the engineer, you know, I'm the doctor, I'm the lawyer, I'm this and that. Well, first and foremost, who made you this and that? Who made you the doctor? Who gave you the ability to get this knowledge into your head? Who gave you the wisdom? First and foremost, you were born, know nothing. When you came out, the only communication skill between you and others was to cry. When you need sleeping, you used to cry. When you are sick, you used to cry. When you are hungry, you used to cry. When you need change and your diapers are wet, you used to cry. That was the only communication skill. And the person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed to recognize those cries from each other and to distinguish this cry from that cry was your mom. Allah gave her that ability to understand easily and to manage you easily so you can thrive easily. Allah is the one who gave you that communication skill. Allah is the one who taught you how to suck the breast or the milk of your from the breast of your mom. Allah is the one who taught you later to speak, to walk, to go to school, to study, and gave you the ability to memorize, to understand. How many people cannot memorize? How many people cannot comprehend and understand simple thing? Allah is the one that gave you this wisdom. Mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your life. All the time say Alhamdulillah. And what happens? La in shakartum la azidannakum. If you give the shukr Allah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says, I will extend it for you and expand it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم.